This tutorial will take you through the ShopSite Setup Wizard in version 12 stores, as well as a few basic functions in your ShopSite store to get you started. Before beginning the 6-step Setup Wizard, you will need to let ShopSite know how much you want ShopSite to create. For the first option, Create My Store, you are letting ShopSite know that it will be creating all of your store pages. For the second option, Add Order Buttons to My Existing Website, you are letting ShopSite know you already have a website or blog and will simply be copying and pasting Add to Cart buttons, or possibly iframes with product information, from ShopSite onto the pages you've created outside of ShopSite. For this tutorial, we will choose Create My Store. Once you've selected an option, ShopSite will take you into the Setup Wizard. The first step is to choose the country where you are located and the currency for your store. As you can see, ShopSite has many options for your country and for your store currency. For this example, however, we will be using the United States and the US dollar. Once you've selected both, click on Next. Step 2, choose your design. You can see here screenshots of the most recently added themes which come with your ShopSite store. All of these themes were created using responsive design. This means these themes will automatically resize your web pages based on the size of the device being used to view them. This allows customers to easily view your website on their smartphones, tablets, desktops, and laptops. Now, if you scroll down, you see the option here for Show More Themes. If we click that, we can see that ShopSite will give us an alphabetical list of all the themes included in your ShopSite store. You can click on each thumbnail for a larger image. On the right, you will see a list of color options for the theme. Selecting a new color will change the image accordingly. When you have decided which theme you wish to use, click Use This Theme. This will automatically take you to the next step in the wizard. You can change your theme at any time under Preferences, Themes. Step 3 is Store Information. This is where you will put in your store name, homepage text, and where you can upload your logo to the store by clicking Select Logo. For this example, our store name will be Glasses and Goggles. Our homepage text will be Welcome to our online store. I don't have a logo at this time, so I'm going to leave that field as it is. Now that we're ready to move on, we're going to select Next. Step 4 is navigation. To make it easier to see what your store can look like, we have included some default images and navigation links for your ShopSite store. You can delete these links if you wish by clicking the X on the right. You can also edit these links by clicking on the pencil icon. Since I have not decided on every page which I will have in my store, I will leave the rest of the default navigation in. I will, however, add a new page. To do that, I will click on Add Page and type in my new page name. Women's Goggles. Now I will click Next. Step 5 is Products. Again, ShopSite has included default products for you so that you can get a feel for your store once it's published. And same as with the pages, you can delete these products by clicking on the little X in the upper right corner. Now I will add a product of my own by clicking on Add Product. The name and price field are required on this page. All other fields are optional. My product name is going to be Blossom and the price is $239. Next, I can upload a product image by clicking on Choose Image. This will allow me to browse my desktop for the picture that I would like to use. When I've found the picture for my product, I simply select it and click Open. This will upload the photo into my ShopSite store. Since I don't have a product description, the last step will be to assign this new product to the page I would like it to appear on. I'm going to choose women's goggles. And you can see the product that I have added. Since I have finished adding all the products I would like to add at this time, I will click on Next. Step 6 is publishing your store. Click on the orange Publish Changes button in the upper right corner. Once your store has been published, ShopSite will prompt you to view your store using the blue View Site button again in the upper right corner. You can see my store name, welcome text, the default pages and products which ShopSite included, and the page which I added during the wizard. By clicking on that link, I can see the product that I added. Let's return to the ShopSite back office. Since I have finished the setup wizard, ShopSite will prompt me to go to the main page of my ShopSite back office by clicking on the logo in the upper left. Now that I have a basic layout for my store, ShopSite has a to-do list of settings which still need to be determined by you, the merchant. Each item on the list is a link directly to that feature. We will not be going over these settings in this tutorial because there are already individual tutorials for these settings. Links to those tutorials can be found either by going to our YouTube page or by going to ShopSite.com, hovering over Demos, and clicking on Video Tutorials. The videos on that page have been organized based on the section of the ShopSite back office where the feature is found. Before we wrap up this tutorial, I would like to show you where you can go to change the pre-populated banner graphic. First, I need to upload the picture I will be using by going to the Images section in the ShopSite back office and clicking on Upload Images. Now that my image has been uploaded, I will go to Pages, click on Advanced Editing, select my index page, and click on Edit Page Content. You can see that there is already an image under Banner Graphic. To change it, I will use the pull-down menu to find my uploaded image in the media directory. Now that I've selected my image, I will scroll to the bottom and save changes. Let's click on Publish Changes and then go to my store and refresh my page to view the new banner graphic. This concludes the ShopSite Setup Wizard tutorial for version 12 stores. Thanks for watching!